Hello viewers, it is the Me and Team. Welcome back to Let's Play Civilization 4 with Julian Assange. And yeah, kind of funny here, I unlocked the Barbarian Uprising event. Or more like, there was a Barbarian Uprising on my borders. And wow, Montezuma Peace Vassal to De Gaulle. That is rather unfortunate for me. I'm now going to have to fight both of them if I want to go to war. But I think I could do it. I really do. Montezuma's stacks are out in La La Land. I'm just going to give them a few turns then, and then I'm going to declare on them both. I can take them. Absolutely can take them. I also took the liberty of purchasing civil service from Suleiman, who still likes me, so doing pretty well on technology still. But yeah, the Barbarian Uprising cannot touch me because I have the Great Wall. So that is for the lols. And that stuff is probably just going to sit there. They'll pick an alternative target city, and I'm probably going to lose this fish. Oh well. But they'll pick like an AI target city, but they can't get there because of the Great Wall. So I can just pick those off at my leisure. Unfortunately, I kind of have my military on other priorities for the moment. No. I'm afraid that is not a possibility. Hopefully I don't piss the Romans off too much. I could maybe give him some stuff to keep him at friendly if he gets too mad at me. I don't know, we'll see. We shall see. Alright, just going to improve this camp. That city's kind of junky. But whatever. Also clearing that. Yeah, just get barracks going. Really nothing putting too much pressure on me here. In fact, I'm going to micromanage my scout for the first time in a while. Just to take a look. So, I really don't think De Gaulle will have too much for me. But I think if he does attack me, it will be in Lagash. I will build walls in Lagash, probably a castle as well. And, yeah, we'll clear this out. Actually, kind of tiles am I working here? I might be able to whip them. Yeah, I can probably whip him and get away with it. I also need to do a little bit of a transfer. Probably like three or four of my longbows. I'll do three down into Lagash in order to defend it. And yeah, I'll just upgrade one, sure. This will give me a little bit of a buffer against the Ottomans. No, I'm going to declare on both of you in a minute. So, quit your complaining. Oh no, maybe that can get to that Barb Galleon time. We shall see. Some City Raider 2 action going on, and yes, settling on the hills, it seemed paranoid maybe. Seemed like it wasn't really worth the while. Is she worst enemies with the Romans as well? She is not. So I can get away with opening borders with her now, and she's actually more powerful than I expected her to be. But that is quite a stack, and yes, this stack is in La La Land. I think it is time, as of next turn, to start throwing down and playing this a little bit more opportunistically than the AI would probably want me to play it. Although he will be taking this city, unfortunately, which Amsterdam is her capital. Yeah, that's gonna suck. Probably take some losses there, but I don't see him being capable. I don't see her being capable of holding on to that for any extended period of time, unfortunately. Anyway, here we go. Not too many trebuchets yet, but you know they don't have any forces, so it's fine. All his forces are down in Hattie's land, and I think Montezuma lost his stuff already. Which is why he was willing to peace vassal. And yeah, I'm going to actually split espionage between the two of them. And okay, here goes. We are going to fight. Yeah, Hattie's really weak, despite her city count. We're going to fight both of these dudes. Yeah, Romans dropped the pleas because I actually technically declared on two of his friends. Hopefully they cannot bribe. No, they shouldn't be able to bribe him. He is far ahead of them in tech, so he'll be willing to declare, but they won't really have anything with which to send over to get him to declare on me. Yeah, just traitor that.
Two cities have been formed by two loves.
And, cottage, mine, and I'm just doing this to reduce micro, improving one tile at a time. It is absolutely more efficient to not do that, but whatever. And I lost out on some resource trades just then, apparently, so gotta worry about happiness in these cities as well. I think I'm going to whip the market. Got fur, ivory, silk, whale. I have three of those. I'll mark it as three happiness for me. And so, and then I get this overflow into military units. That should work out pretty well. Crossbowman does the, he has horse, but I have elephant, so it does not matter. I do not have to worry about knights nearly as much as I might otherwise. And yeah, oh wow, actually Montezuma captured that. And we're looking at a lot of losses. So these guys really, we're talking about me catching them with their pants pulled down. They are not in good shape right now. I did that on purpose, actually. Decided to be a little opportunistic. And it's paying off. Unfortunately, I'm not going to really be able to steal anything of consequence in the near future. But it doesn't really matter. And yeah, he's got knights coming. So I have to watch. To watch my back. I'm probably going to leave an extra longbow in there or something. I lost a unit. Oh, I lost my random scout. Well, that's not really unexpected. I can't expect to keep him under those conditions. Going to whip a theater as well, and then just start on more war elephants and trebuchets. Trebuchets, so good. Yeah, just explore that scouter. Well, I don't know what I lost. What did I lose? I think it would be worthwhile looking since I still had the scout, apparently. Oh no, it was one of my scouts. I had two scouts. Oh, that's right, and I had them on auto-explore. Okay. No, apparently... Oh, because he keeps his master status, that's why. I was like, why is it not showing him at war? Oh well. This worker, I can actually use a road there to open up a pass into that territory. I noticed that De Gaulle and Montezuma are gifting each other texts. That is why I hate peace vassals in this game. The AI treats it like a permanent alliance and not a temporary arrangement like it technically is. Alright, they decided to attack me with a catapult. No big deal. I'm just gonna bombard a little bit. Yeah, it'll be a slow war, but that doesn't really matter. I can wall it. I can take it. I can make it last and blast Montezuma off this continent. He would probably give up after that. I hope he drops his peace vassal after that. It'd be really annoying if he doesn't. Yeah, I can go next turn, take this city. He's got a pike in this city. But like I said, with the swordsmen and the longbows, the pikes really aren't going to threaten elephants that much. So that's, I shouldn't have to worry. And yeah, now I got some trebuchets coming in. I'll be able to do a lot of damage to cities with City Raider 2 trebs, which are quite imposing, actually. They're not cannons, viewers, which are amazing, but they do their job. And yeah, I've got three longbows and an archer in there, and I will have a castle next turn. Probably don't want to go too heavy on the elephants. A lot of cities building them already, so we'll do this. Add some more crossbows to my forces. Also, from now on, I'm going to want to rally to Lagash, because that's where I'm going to be launching my next assault. And I have enough forces up here where I can just reinforce from Lagash to Montezuma. And apparently he has invested in castles. So I'm going to want to invest in something to counter castles, namely spies. Where is a good city to build some spies? Get out of my way. Sure, we'll build a couple right here. Oops. And this is why I'm still investing espionage points on them. Not in a hurry to get them into his territory yet, but soon. And okay, here we go. A City Raider 2 trebuchet against a non-protective longbow will have 75% odds on the very first conflict. That is good. That is solid. And that will definitely soften them up quickly. Catapults, not as good, as you can see. And I really need to use them, though, because the enemy has pikes in the city, and I want to clear out those as being an issue. And now I can just sweep the city with elephants. So, yeah. Kind of kind of works. Maybe leave two longbows in the city. There we go. Emphasize hammers. Granary for sure first, then like so. How am I doing on religion? Apparently someone has been spreading it for me, which is very nice. Alright, I'm actually going to go up here first, because that's less worry about counterattacks from our little friends in the south. And actually, plus I don't have to bombard it. Let's check out what he's got in that. Okay, he's got nothing. He's actually doing really terrible shape. Apparently I fought that barb galley, did not realize it. They can't spawn down here any longer, so I'm just going to heal up. And, oh wow. Alright, well, if I were to have a 100% slider, did I put one in this city yet? I did not. I think that's the city I decided would be next, however. Yeah, bad Tiber. Look at this. With 100%, if I can just grind out so much espionage so quickly if I need it. But I don't. Anyway, another Scotland Yard there. Scotland Yards are actually really good if you have a lot of commerce. I mean, you're talking the equivalent of, like, library, academy, and, like, observatory or university. In any city, you can get it. No, I don't really need to pay to have Lost Grain replaced. It's not necessary. Now I've got a road here. But this is on a hill, so that's not going to help me out. So I just need to farm and get over there. Okay. Got some spies. As long as he doesn't build a castle, I should be fine. And probably want an escort for my trebuchets up here. So I'm going to send another unit or two up there and just build a Scotland Yard. Yeah, it doesn't look impressive now, but that's because I have my slider down. Really been abusing the AI this game. And this is kind of fun. What does he have to say? He wants me to give him back Lagash. No, Lagash is mine. He wants me to give him Lagash. But I'm stronger than you. Or no, we're the same strength. Apparently got a mace attacking my war elephant. That is my cue to upgrade my war elephant to promotions. Yeah, no pikes there. So I'm just going to pay him back by killing his mace. Awesome. And everyone else can kind of just bombard, clear out the defenses. Apparently already. Okay. Can Barb spawn down here? I don't think so yet, so I'm going to go defend the fish. And where was my plantation destroyed? I don't know. Oh, right here. That will take care of that without any trouble. And yeah, the reason I'm massing here is I just don't trust... Wow, the Ottomans are kind of thinned out, actually. Now that I've espionage on them and can see their cities. This is really De Gaulle's best effort. So I just need to keep Hattie from capping. Even if she does, though, I can probably take them. This is really a well-placed backstab. And I just lost the city, I think. Or, I don't get it. What? While defending your Archer 5, air due. Oh, I see. It was a longbow that was upgraded. See, and what killed it? Persian knight. Ouch. Ouch. It's time to leave some elephants back, I think. Taking a few city raider promotions. Yeah. Okay, I lost my trebuchet. That's annoying to me. But, looks like I'm going to take this out just fine. Apparently I need to leave some elephants behind in my effort to play defense. I probably don't need too many, though. Just this one plus a longbow. There we go. And shoot, it does not look like I can reach that city easily. And, okay, we got an elephant, crossbow, and three trebuchets. They can move on. And build some cottages. Absolutely. I'm kind of hoping that he, the Ottomans decide that it's a good idea to attack my castle wall city down there with all the longbows in it. That would be very entertaining to me. to defend that city. Well, he doesn't look like he's doing anything to protect his peace vassal, though. And the Aztec, or I should say Persian Empire's power continues to plummet as a result. Probably want to get some spies in this city to drop its defenses. I'm going to have a hard time bombarding that down with my two little siege right now. And come on, make it. No, I did not make it. Well, okay. I'm going to have to take that back. But nothing I can do there. I mean, I was taking a risk and I paid. So, yes. Can I masterfully bait the worker out? I might be able to do that. Or bait them out to attack the worker with the knight. We'll see. We shall see. I have a lot of gold. I could consider buying paper. In fact, I really don't have any reason not to. So we'll just do that.
I cannot live without
sure.
Books.
I like how this city, despite the fact that I bombarded it down completely, already has defenses and, wow, quite a few units. Right off the bat. So this Montezuma being pretty on the lame side, I should say. I do have my medic here. I'm going to wait a turn and let this stuff become a factor as well. Trebuchets are good enough where they can make a difference. Even against the knights. And yeah, I'm getting more and more units, so I should be fine there. So many castles. You are going to be on permanent spy duty. And am I really unhappy? No, just a little bit. Apostolic Palace is available. Come on, somebody I want build it, please. That would be awesome. Apparently he really cleared out his forces to put them in this city, though. Which is not wise. It's not on a hill. And I should be able to sweep it without too much trouble again. 58% odds because I'm attacking a knight. Okay. And 81% odds and 91.2. So that worked out. Pretty much crushed their knights with my trebuchets. And awesome, we are going to take this city back. Yeah, I think the crossbow is fine. Crossbow beating a knight. Yeah, I'll move elephants in here, and I'm actually going to regroup in here. I did not think I was going to do that at first, but the Aztecs decided to slow me down a little bit. So I'm just going to go ahead and move into this city and bring my forces up from my wall city to bolster my defenses up there. Just grabbing a few of these. Because it does not seem like the Ottomans have any interest in actually helping out the Persians in this conflict. So I have no incentive. And looks like I need to whip some more markets. And again, markets are usually not a good deal. But right now you are talking a huge benefit from them. Because they are +3 happiness building. And I'm going to make a scout here. Seems a little bit counterintuitive, but I'll show off why. Or do I have a scout already? I have a scout already. I'm going to not make a scout then. And the scout will be my super medic. Yeah, I'm just going to leave him there to protect my trebuchets. Where is he getting the horse for knight? Probably up there. And why is he still De Gaulle's vassal? De Gaulle's not doing a good job of protecting him, even in the slightest. So yeah, I have some regular medic elephants that will help out until I can get my super medic up there. And I'll just use this chance to, you know, kind of set up my defenses and move on. You know, it doesn't really matter that the war is going slowly because there's no one threatening. It's kind of weak. Get the forge there. Okay, get there. I don't know what I'm doing with my scout, but I think that's close enough. And cottages. Oh no, you're farming. I definitely need to spread irrigation there. Come on, Montezuma. Actually, blow a turn. Don't blow a turn move in there. I'm going to put my spies into position so that I can just spy revolt this before I take it. Drastically cutting the amount of time I need to bombard the city. And yeah, that barbarian uprising is still there. Kind of weird. That's how the game does it, though. And okay, well, I don't have a super medic yet. I'm going to leave my crossbow behind, a couple elephants, even my sword, because I have more stuff in this garrison, and I want a variety of units that don't get hosed. So yeah, just do that. That should be good enough against the random knights and anything else that would come after me. Apparently now we have an enemy knight trying to screw around in my territory, so that's no good. Medic 1, Medic 2, Medic 3. Get back in there. Just two knights, though. I do have to watch my flanks, because they tend to run around and then try to capture a back city. But I have enough money to upgrade and whatever, so hopefully I do not run into too much trouble. And if I can just get another elephant, there we go. Could use some better roading in my territory as well. But okay. Oh, actually, the Aztecs have a... I keep saying Aztecs. The Persians have a bunch of catapults there to make life unpleasant for me. And he is apparently opting to counterattack. So I'm going to need to defend myself. And we will do that like this. Just get a longbow whipped in right away. Overflow into maybe another longbow or two. This small of a force attacking like three longbows on a hill will not do anything at all. So no worries there. And, yeah, just get a little bit closer to Susa. It's so annoying with the frickin' castles. And I can't get over there without risking my great general yet, so I won't. But, it's hopefully soon. And, yeah, these hill cities have a lot of strategic value. And yet another game where they are coming into play, surprisingly. I never used to take advantage of that. I definitely want to keep my eye on these knights. He's going to take his time bombarding, and I do have walls here, so that should be fine. City Garrison 2. Yeah, we're talking like these things are stronger than a rifle would be on the in the field while they're in cities. So they're going to screw them up. And apparently the knights are content to just sit here and pillage for the moment. Here we go. Support city revolt. Drops the defenses for one turn completely because cities in revolt have no defenses. And that opens up trebuchet attacks. Got very lucky there with like 20% odds against that city garrison 2 longbow defending it. And yeah, now this is going to be cleanup. So no trebuchets lost there at all. And that is what I like to see. Yeah, grab an elephant, and maybe two longbows, two. Oh my god. Well, since the user interface is still crap, we will just do this. And yeah, now the city also won't have any defenses in the future either, because it's not his city. And yeah, just now we can chuck a couple longbows in here. And yeah, that's the fun way to quote-unquote bombard in the Middle Ages, and because I'm running an espionage economy anyway, it is much better than it normally would be. And I'm just gonna chop this. Can I reach? I cannot reach. I can't even come close to reaching. So these knights are causing me issues, although not for the same reasons that one might normally expect. Bombard. Oh, got more longbow coming in here. But by the time they finish bombarding, I'll have another longbow, and they will not get anything done. That's horrible! Fire ants! Oh no. And what just happened? I just got into a bunch of fights and won them. Oh no, that's different. Where is the fighting? Okay, whatever. Anyway, these knights are blocking my path, and I can kill them easily, so I'm going to do it. Oh, maybe not. Maybe not so easily. Oh, and Montezuma has renounced the protection. and become a vassal on the same turn. Come on, game. The game could be so lame with this kind of stuff. And yeah, elephants really work in the field here. They're so good. They make classical war much more palatable than they might otherwise be. And what can take combat? I think it's my crossbow. My siege can't. Well, okay. Just get in there. Heal up. That knight's going to cause me trouble. I'm not sure. Yeah, I'll just let the elephant die rather than something else. And then clean up the knight afterwards. I really want to open that. Oh, the knight's attacked here. Okay, like two Aztec knights that you saw, or Persian knights that you saw. They were attacking my forces here, I believe, and did nothing. They got walled. So, very nice. I can definitely live with the Aztecs getting screwed over by attacking my defenses. Makes life very easy on me. And yeah, this is really annoying here. This four swordsman with a lighthouse. I'm just going to whip down there and maybe try and sneak this worker by. I'm going to do a run by. I'm going to go there and then drop down, because it's not like I'm losing out on trade routes. So, whatevs. Yeah, ziggurat. Organized ziggurats are so cheap. I love them. They're awesome. Apparently Mad Scientist wanted to make this a pretty easy game, I guess. I don't know. I'm fighting quite miserably in tech here. But I'm huge. I have a lot of territory already. Pretty sure I'm number one in population. Pretty sure I'm doing well in general. Yes, I am. Number one in pop. Number one in soldiers? Really? Wow, okay. With my cottage empire, I'm number one in soldiers and number one in production. I think it's just because of the sheer number of cities. Yep, he killed my war elephant. But that is not too bad. Do I get a longbow next turn? I do. So I'll have three longbows to defend against four catapults, a sword, and an immortal. He can't possibly take that in one turn because he doesn't have enough units that can actually kill units. But, you know, even... You know, I don't think he's enough to even win the fight. Aw, oh, man. This is so obnoxious. Okay, let's look carefully. Longbow there. But that's in my border, so it can't move twice. Nothing here can reach down there. And I don't really have anything else, so... Alright, I'm going to hop here, and then I should be able to make it into Susa on the following turn. Just grab a little city garrison too to hose up the AI. And yeah, oh, nope, wait till next turn for your run by. Ziggurat. Always ziggurats. And are the Ottomans doing anything? The Ottomans are not doing anything. Like, I don't even see him... Where are his forces? Is he still going for Hattie? I don't get it. I should check the espionage, make sure I can incite a revolt on Montezuma. I can do so. And will he... No, he's still a peace vassal, permanent alliance vassal, I should say. Passel. It is. It's not a peace vassal. It is a permanent alliance vassal. It is a mechanic designed for the AI to create a permanent alliance. There's really no arguing otherwise. Alright, yeah, now you can get over there. So I will spend one more turn healing, and then I will be able to drag my forces out and take the Persian capital. In a war that's gone pretty well for me, all things considered. And largely tech parity, Emperor fighting against AI bonuses. But who cares, you know? It's... I have more cities, and AI is stupid, and those two things together make me win. Defending on hill cities, has spy revolting them. He's still willing to sell me some stuff. Maybe I should just buy it. I really don't have any better alternative uses of money. Yeah, just give me this stuff.
The wisest men follow their some own direction. To be
I know Matt intended this for this to be an espionage game, but I mean, whatever. Not get the spy demerits. I have plenty of espionage potential if I want it or need it at any time. And okay. Now, I want to be a little careful here. I don't want to lose any units. I don't want to lose the city back to the Ottomans. So I'm going to leave 2 war elephants and 2 longbows behind. And that should still be enough stack to actually take out the Persian capital regardless. And I will bring the great general with me on this excursion. Apparently he decided just not to attack. Okay. Well, let's heal up. If I get lucky, he'll just break free once I take his capital and I can capitulate him. And that should really gum up all the future capitulation odds, which is fine for a game like this. Yeah, now they're starting to fall behind in technology as well. And if I got to guilds, I'd make some knights maybe. Nah, I don't know. Elephants are pretty good, pretty solid. With enough combat promotions, they even fight pretty well against muskets, so I really don't have to worry about anything into like grenadiers and rifles. Or cavalry. Cavalry in particular, because it would flank my siege, and that is just not... that's not cool. Getting siege flanked really hurts. Yeah, just improve the tile. Maybe you can do another run-by. You know, then there's a chance that those lemming scripts that those are running, they wouldn't even attack the worker, they would just stay in place. But I don't trust it. I do not trust that from the game. Yeah, okay. I'm gonna get the +1 commerce prairie dogs. Really? For a change, that was my own fault. I'm amazed. Aw, come on, game. Seriously? There's a good chance he will take that city back. Apparently I'm gonna get a revolt as well. Awesome. Let's see here. He's gonna probably lose a number of catapults. Actually, this is a hill city, and I have city garrisoned 2 longbows. It is not guaranteed that he will successfully take it, but I'll bring these elephants out. And the most he can do is attack this city with 1 knight, and then I can get forces back there if he chooses to do that. And run by next turn. I can finally patch up the farm. Oh no, I got my farm pillaged here. Very annoying. They're trying to interrupt my irrigation spread. Okay. Well, yeah, and surprisingly, Montezuma is still hanging out. Can I whip a walls? Oh man. Suck on 50% defenses. Yeah, now he has to bombard, see? Screw you, AI. Support a city revolt, and this is not even on a hill, so this goes from being a long, painful bombard process to like 1 unit lost, and I'm going to take the city. And if I do take it, then I'll probably be cleared of culture and can turn around and get right back into the city that is under threat. Yes, that is exactly how this is going to work out. So he was a little bit too slow to threaten this city again, and now I am definitely going to wall him. So a little run by here. I love run bys. Zergling run bys are cool. So yeah, horse archer there. I don't know why this elephant didn't like have its pathing interrupted, because there's a horse archer in its path, but it didn't. And actually, I can just attack this, and I'm going to do it from the city though. But yeah, I can just hit it now. Say what? Okay, I should really invest in Heroic Epic City now. I have literature because I purchased it. Printing press would be awesome, but I'm gonna need to. I'm gonna need to make some more money before I can get it. It would pump up so many of my cottages, though. But yeah, I should invest in a Heroic Epic City and put this great general in that city. So let's look at my production and power buildings. Hammers. Saxon and Larsa? I don't know, my eyes are bad. No, I don't have a city named Larsa. What is it, Lagash? No. What the hell? Why is Saxon my best production city? Is it because I'm chopping? No, it's because that I'm misreading the report. It's probably this. There we go. This is more realistic. Where are you, Umma? That's a good question. Oh, it's here. Really? That's actually not bad. Okay, sure. Alright then, build Heroic Epic there, which is also not going to interfere with any other long-term plans for other cities. And that's fine. Greenery. Lighthouse. I really need him to capitulate to me, though, because otherwise I'm never going to get to work those seafoods. And he shouldn't, he really shouldn't be DeGaulle's vassal any longer. I mean, he's kind of lost the protection that he was so desiring. Still bombarding me. Probably not going to work out for you there, guy. Is he free yet? He is not free yet. I functionally eliminated him from being a contention, though. So I should be fine here. Just going to get back into this city and heal up again. And alright, I've made some good progress in this one. So in the next part, we are going to be taking on DeGaulle instead of Montezuma. So I will see you then. Thumbs up if you like this video. Thumbs down if you don't. The Mian team signing off.